In the early 1970s, an escalating conflict between Denver and its surrounding suburbs launched one of the bitterest battles in Colorado legislative history. Responding to Denver's thirst for land in the profitable southeast suburbs, Frieda Poundstone, a Republican activist from Greenwood Village, spearheaded a drive to pass a controversial amendment to the state constitution. Poundstone's suburban coalition was ostensibly threatened by the loss of tax revenues from the city's land grab. But for many, the move was designed to dodge a more urgent issue, Denver's federal mandate to integrate schools with court-ordered busing. The Poundstone Amendment passed in 1974, splitting Denver from its metropolitan neighbors. Facing the prospect of a restricted inner city surrounded by growing prosperity, Denver was forced to look inward for solutions. If it could not grow out, it would have to grow up. And in the mid-1970s, downtown Denver was poised and ready. Vacant land left in the wake of urban renewal and a burgeoning energy boom fueled an office-building frenzy as skyscrapers shot into the Colorado sky in defiant response to Poundstone. Within 20 years, Denver would be a thriving example of successful revitalization of its urban core.